فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
عبد السابق, you're the لاحق. Your level of a narration, or he might even die. You've got a long chain for many people to come to take from you. Does that make sense? تفضل.
وإن روى عن اثنين متفقي الاسم ولم يتميزا فباختصاصه بأحدهما يتبين المهمل.
This is the مهمل. It's somebody who's named بما لا يتميز به. We can't distinguish him. He mentioned somebody. He mentioned Hamad. Which Hamad is he talking about? Is it Hamad ibn Salama? Is it Hamad ibn Zayd? But we can't tell. Is Ibn Hajar mentioned here right now? After looking at Hamad ibn Salama is unique for somebody who he narrates from. Sufyan ibn Uyayna and Sufyan al-Thawri, it's easy to tell the difference between the two of them. One of the ways to tell is each person is uniquely known for a particular person he narrates from. So when we see Ibham here, when we see Ihmal here and it's Muhmal, and Sufyan said this, is it Thawri, is it Uyayna? It will be told after looking at who he narrated from. Ibn Hajar mentions that for you. Hey?
وإن جحد الشيخ مرويه جزما رد وإن أو احتمالا قبل في الأصح وفيه من حدث ونسي.
Here's a chapter that the author is talking about is a person who narrated a hadith and then he rejects the hadith. I narrated a hadith and you say to me, Shaykh, this is your hadith. I say, Abdan, never, I never said this. Well, you say, Shaykh, you narrated it to me. No, never, leave me alone. It's a problem now, you can't move forward. The teacher that you're going to use as a chain is rejecting this narration. The author then says, this is two situations, he mentions them both. The first one is, he rejects it, مَرْوِيَّهُ جَزْمًا. He says, yes, this is not mine. Wallahi, this is not mine. People, isma. Wallahi, this is not mine. And he's doing it with unwavering conviction. And he's convinced that's not his. Then your narration is rejected, O student of knowledge. The second one is ihtimalan. He's like, I don't know, man. You don't think this is mine. The Shaykh said, فَيُقْبَلُ عَلَى الْأَصَحِيِّ. It's accepted this time. This time, if he's skeptical about it, we'll take it from him. And he said, this enters the chapter which is what? وَفِيهِ مَنْ حَدَّثَ وَنَسِي. The chapter known as what? The one who narrates and forgets. And there's a book written by Jalaluddin al-Suyuti. He's got a juz small on scholars who that happened to them. في من حدث ونسي. Suyuti رحمه الله wrote a book on it. هيا سعر 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 هريا.
وإن اتفق الرواة في صغير الأداء.
Something في من حدث ونسي. جزء في من حدث ونسي.
وإن اتفق الرواة في صيغ الأداء أو غيرها من الحالات فهو المسلسل.
Now the author speaks about the issue of مسلسل. A hadith which is known as musalsal. A hadith that's known as musalsal is a hadith that people pass on to each other. First of all, the Shaykh said here, Ibn Hajar, أو غيرها من الحالات. حالات, he used it as a مؤنث. This is not fasih. It's not eloquent. It's wrong according to the Arabic language. حالات is not used as a مؤنث. It's used as a مذكر. It's seen مع المدرتي. Rare that somebody would use that. وَالْإِحَاطَةُ لِلَّهِ. Only Allah encompasses knowledge, صح? Only Allah تبارك وتعالى is one who is أحاط بكل شيء. So حالات is the جمع of حالتين, right? Have you ever seen the word حالتين? حالتين بتأنيث? لا لا لا, that goes against the Arabic language. It's a كلمة مذكرة لفظاً in its construction and its binya. It's مذكر. But it is مؤنثة المعنى. The معنى can be مؤنث. That's another مسألة. Which we say اعتباره بلفظه and اعتباره بمعنى. على كل حال, the Shaykh Suris not said حالات. Anyways, the point is the مسلسل here. The hadith which is a مسلسل is a hadith that's passed on to each other that each narrator is saying to the narrator after him something. And generally speaking, as a side benefit, majority of the hadith which are مسلسل are weak. Not the hadith is weak, but the tasalsul is weak. For example, what did the Prophet say to Mu'adh? Wallahi inni la'uhibbuk, right? The Sahabi Mu'adh passed it on and he said, Wallahi inni la'uhibbuk, to the person who he told. And the person who he told said to the next person, Wallahi inni la'uhibbuk, when he told him the hadith. I love you, take this from me. And it went on, and even when your teacher tells you, he says to you, Wallahi inni la uhibbuk, fala tada'anna fi dub. And this is called tasalsul. Does that make sense? This is called it. Or everybody tells you this narration laughing. Then when the Prophet said, why don't you guys ask me why I'm laughing? Allah laughed. And then Sahabi said, why don't you ask me why I'm laughing? Because the Prophet laughed. And Allah laughed. And everybody goes on saying the same thing, until it reaches you. And you ask the people, why are you guys not going
to ask? So it happens to be direct, insane, but actually something that occurred.
So generally, if you look at the chain, you're always going to find that it's weak, it's disconnected somewhere. It can't carry on like that. Yeah? Naam, the example of the Shaykh, he brings his chain, right? Ar-Rahimun, Yarhamun, Ar-Rahman, sah? He always brings that Shaykh Usaymi, and he tells, my teacher told me, and they bring, that's another musalsal. مسلسل قل ما على وصف أتى مثل أما والله أنبأني الفتاة كذاك قد حدث لي قائما وبعد أن حدث لي تبسم. Everyone's smiling when they're telling the narration. صح؟ This is what مسلسل is. هي؟ We'll take questions later, shall I?
صيغ الأداء سمعت وحدثني ثم أخبرني وقرأت عليه ثم قرئ عليه وأنا أسمع ثم أنبأني ثم ناولني ثم شافهني ثم كتب إلي ثم عن ونحوها. فالأولان لمن سمع وحده لمن لفظ الشيخ فإن جمع فما فمع غيره وأولها أصرحها وأرفعها في الإملاء والثالث والرابع لمن قرأ بنفسه فإن جمع فهو كالخامس والإنباء بمعنى الإخبار إلا في عرف المتأخرين فهو للإجازة كعن وعنعنة المعاصر محمولة على السماع إلا من المدلس وقيل يشترط ثبوت لقائهما ولو مرة وهو المختار وأطلقوا المشافهة في الإجازة المتلفظ بها والمكاتبة في الإجازة المكتوب بها واشترطوا في صحة المناولة اقترانها بالإذن بالرواية وهي أرفع أنواع الإجازة وكذا اشترطوا الإذن في الوجادة والوصية بالكتابة والإعلان وإلا فلا عبرة بذلك كالإجازة العامة وللمجهول وللمعدوم على الأصح في جميع ذلك ثم الرواة إن اتفقت أسماؤهم وأسماء آبائهم فصاعدا واختلفت أشخاصهم فهو المتفق والمفترق وإن اتفقت الأسماء خطا واختلفت نطقا فهو المؤتلف والمختلف وإن اتفقت الأسماء واختلفت الآباء أو بالعكس فهو المتشابه وكذا إن وقع ذلك الاتفاق في اسم واسم أب والاختلاف في النسبة ويتركب منه ومما قبله أنواع منها أن يحصل الاتفاق أو الاشتباه إلا في حرف أو حرفين أو بالتقديم والتأخير ونحو ذلك.
The author رحمه الله تعالى, he now talks about a different type of علوم الحديث which is known as صياغ الأداء. When you're passing on a narration, how do you do it? Which is the question that was asked by you. حدثنا and أخبرنا and أنبأنا. We need to know a bit about this now. This is known as صياغ الأداء. What is it known as? صياغ الأداء means the form of conveying. How do you convey a narration? The author mentioned eight. He mentions eight levels. Eight levels of how it's passed on. The first one is سمعت وحدثني. Are you with me? The first one is what? سمعت وحدثني. The second one is أخبرني وقرأت عليه. So the first one is سمعت وحدثني. The second one is أخبرني وقرأت عليه. The fourth one is The third one is قُرِئَ عَلَيْهِ. Are you with me? The fourth one is أَنْبَأَنِي. The fourth one is أَنْبَأَنِي. Fifth one is نَاوَلَنِي. The fourth one is أنبأني. Fifth one is ناولني. Sixth one is شافهني. Eighth one is عن. Sorry, عم. Seventh one is كتب إلي. كتب إلي. Eighth one is عن. I can count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just so you guys think I can't count. The eighth one is عن. The sixth one is شافهني. Let's go from all of them. The first one is سمعت وحدثني. سمعت and حدثني. I heard him. And this one is direct, strongest, powerfulest form of تحمل. It's the strongest form of taking on a narration. It's the strongest الفاظ المعبرة, which is I heard, he told me. The second one, which is what? أخبرني وقرأت عليه. This is what's known as العرض. It's to present to the Shaykh. أخبرني هي وقرأت عليه. أما القراءة عليه when he أخبرني قرأت عليه and etc. This is known as what? عرض is to present to the teacher. So أخبرني doesn't mean you were reading it. So he was reading it. He never told you. أخبرني, you were reading it to him. Are you with me, brothers? أخبرني, the reading was coming from you to him. He was listening. You were presenting the hadith to him. Whereas حدثني and سمعت means he was saying it. You were hearing it from him. Same is with أنبأني. Are you there, brothers? But أنبأني has now turned into our time as إجازة. إجازة is أنبأني for us. That's what the author says. والإنباء بمعنى الإخبار إلا في عرف المتأخرين فهو للإجازة. أنبأني is, it means إخبار to tell. But according to the متأخرين is turned into the word إجازة. And we'll talk about what إجازة is. Are you with me, brothers? The fourth one is munawala. Huh? Huh? So I'm emerging them now. The ones who have the same rulings, I'm giving it the same. Let's go back. Sami'tu hadathani is what? It's the first one. What is it? Who's saying it? The Shaykh is saying it. It's Sama' min lafzati al-Shaykh. Yeah, I mean min lafzati al-Shaykh. The Shaykh's wording. He's saying it, you're hearing it. Okay. The second one is what? Ard. Within Ard, I emerged a lot. صح? I put in there, أخبرني, قرأت عليه, قرئ عليه, وأنا أسمع, أنبأني, all of those are all of those are عرض أما القراءة عليه. Third, الإجازة. The third one is what? الإجازة. When a person says أجازني فلان, فلان gave me a إجازة. أو أخبرني إجازة. You write the eight that the author mentioned. Now I'm going to start putting them into categories where they enter into the chapters. Fourth one is مناولة. مناولة means the author gives you his book and he allows you to narrate from it. He writes everything in a particular book, صح? Huh? Like this, yeah, right now, we have his, in his kitab at the ending, Al-Shaykh Usaymi. Right now, I can just give you ijaz of his book, but he hasn't given me the permission. The munawwala needs al-idhn. Bishart idhn, the author mentions it. You have permission? Okay, Tira, you're going to give it to everybody then. Give it to everyone. You guys should all have it from Sheikh Yasin then. Are you with me, brothers? So he's going to he's got the ijaz of the sheikh, he passes it to everybody. That's munawala. It's a form of ijazah, right? The fifth one is al-mukataba. The author he writes to you. It's kataba ilayya. He wrote to me. He writes a hadith to you. Al-wasiyya means... The next one is, the sixth one is called al-wasiyya. Wasiyya means he gives a farewell. He says, Fulan, when I die, he is the one who can narrate from my book. He gives it. The seventh one is i'lam. The seventh one is al-i'lam. So the person would say, a'lamani fulan fulan told me about it. He educated me regarding it. So he's not going to give you this narration. So example, I will come to you, like for example, Yasin would stand up right now and he will tell everybody, Ikhwa, ta'ala. All of you, this is my ijazah. And he reads out the ijazah for us. No one can say, oh, it's mine, jazakallah, you read it out and I got it from you. La, he's only informing you of the sanad. Does that make sense? You can't use him as a shaykh. This is called i'lam. Is when he informs you of his sama', the narrations he heard. Are you with me, brothers? Unless he gives you permission. All of these, they need permission. You can't claim it. The last one, which is al-wijada. Wijada means you find the book of Yasin on a shelf. You open it, you say, I'm going to read the asanid from it. Again, you need a permission for that. Are you with me? Yasin gives me permission. He says, Abdurrahman, I've heard about you, mashallah, you're a person who's strong in hadith. I'm going to send you my book, you can narrate from it straight away. So a flying book comes to me in London, I open it, and I'll say, Ajazani, he gave me ijazah, and I'll read all the narrations to you guys. Abuthu fikum. I spread it amongst you. This is called what? Wijada. 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 Yeah? Which one did he say? Shafan is when he does, it's not a which mean awjuhu tahammul, it's not generally. It's just when the person clearly tells you mushafahatan that he's giving you ijazah on this. Like he says it to you by mouth. There's no writing for you have. I tell you people, wallahi, the sheikh gave me mushafahatan. He said to me, you are allowed to narrate from me. Mushafahatan, that's what it means. Aya? Then the author, he mentioned something very powerful here. He went into the issue of an'ana. He mentioned حكم العنعنة الراوي. The an'ana of a rawi who's mu'asar when it comes to taking on the itzalat and etc. So for example, if a person, he does an, and he's not a mu'asir, then this hadith is munqati', we can clearly all see it, there's no problem, right? But what about if he's a mu'asir, he resided at the same time and uses the word an. If he's a mudallis, then Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he wrote a book regarding the maratib al-mudallisin. He has a book called Ta'arifu Ahlu Taqdis bimaratib al-masrufina bil-tadlis. So you go there, you look at the level of which level this person is, and you deal with it over there. As for if he's free from an'ana, if he's not a person who's known to be a mudallis, and he uses the word an, it's mahmoola ala tisal. They take it as though it's connected. Right? Does that make sense? So you mentioned something before that. Then you got the author rahimahullah mentioned three types of the types of science in the science of hadith, and it is اتفاق أسماء الرواة واختلافها. He mentioned three points here. The first one is known as المتفق والمفترق. المتفق والمفترق. It means, the author defines it, it means أسماء آبائهم فصاعدا واختلفت أشخاصهم. The name of the narrator and the name of his fathers are the same. We've got the same name and the same father's name, but we're two different people. So we agree on the name. So we all agree on the name, but we're two different people. So it's muftafiq. Muftafiq in what? في الاسم. مفترق in what? في الأشخاص. You're a different person from who I am, but we still have the same name. Then comes the next point was what? المؤتلف والمختلف. المؤتلف والمختلف is what? The wording is written the same. The wording is written the same, but the pronunciation is different, like Hibban and Habban. It's pronounced different. It's written the same, but it's pronounced different. That's called Mu'talif. In terms of the writing, are they the same? They're Mu'talif. They're Mukhtalif in what? So Mu'talifun fil khatti, Mukhtalifun fil nutqi, in the pronunciation. Then the third one which he mentioned, which is the Mutashabih. Their names are the same, but the names of their father are different. Or the opposite. Their name is the same. I said the names of their fathers is the same, but their name is different. Now the author mentions the last khatima, last chapter.
ومن المهم معرفة طبقات الرواة ومواليدهم ووفياتهم وبلدانهم وأحوالهم تعديلا وتجريحا وجهالة.
The author رحمه الله, here he goes into, and this is the last chapter that he mentions in this book of his, Ibn Hajar رحمه الله, and it's something that is necessary for every student of knowledge. لطالب الحديث, a person of hadith, something is obligatory and it should come with. It is to busy yourself to give consideration to these things that he mentions. And the Shaykh mentions, rahimahullah, he mentions five things that you should know. The first one is tabaqat al-ruwat, the levels of the narrators. What does it mean, tabaqat al-ruwat? It is scholars, ruwat, narrators who come together either in age or who they took from. So anybody who you see in who they took from or their age, this is a tabaqah. So I'm going to ask you later, what's a tabaqah? You're going to tell me, fi sinni, in their age, or will akhdi, or who they took from. Are you with me? The second one he mentions is mawalidhum, their birthplace, when they were born. Tarikhu wiladat al-ruwat, when were the narrators born? The third one is wafayatuhum, when did they die? When did they die? Number fourth is buldanuhum, the lands in which they resided and they stayed, or the lands that they were born, all of that. Last but not least, the fifth one, which is ahwaluhum, their situation. When he says ahwaluhum, he means min jihati al-adalati wa tajrihi wal jahala. If they are unknown, if they are praised, if they're criticized, every person try to learn that much from them. Five things you try to learn from every narrator. Then the author, rahimahullah, mentions four matters after that. The author mentions after that four things. Faddal.
ومراتب الجرح وأسوأها الوصف بالأفعال كأكذب الناس ثم دجال أو وضاع أو كذاب وأسهلها لين أو سيء الحفظ أو فيه أدنى مقال ومراتب التعديل وأرفعها الوصف بأفعال كأوثق الناس ثم ما تأكد بصفة أو صفتين كثقة ثقة أو ثقة حافظ وأدناها ما أشعر بالقرب من أسهل التجريح كشيخ.
The author رحمه الله, now he mentions four things pertaining to الجرح والتعديل. Number one, مراتب الجرح والتعديل. The levels of جرح and تعديل. The levels of praise and disparagement. So what does it mean, the levels of disparagement? It means the stations that show the weakness of a narrator, or this person is strong, levels. That if he goes up, he's becoming more stronger, and if he goes down, he's becoming more weaker. The author mentions that. And he mentions different wordings that are used that show it. That's the first point that he mentions. And he gave examples. Rahimahullah, the worst is what? Anything that's mentioned with the usage of the word af'al. For example, if they say akdabun nasi, that's the worst. Akdabun nas is not just like a kadab. Akdabun nas means he's the biggest liar on the face of this earth. The second one is dajjal or wadda'. Then after that comes kadab. So these are big, this is the highest levels. It's akdabun nas, dajjalun, wadda'un, kadhabun. Those four are, subhanallah. Then comes after that, layyinun. This is simple. Wa ashaluha, he says, it's very light. It's layyinun. Sayyul hifd, fi adna maqal. So you say layyinun, he's what? Layyin is light. Sayyul hifd means what? His memory is bad. فِيهِ أَدْنَى مَقَالٍ. He's below any state, like any maqal, you say, any statement. He's slightly below it. And then he mentions the مَرَاتِبُ التَّعْدِيلِ, which is the level of ta'dil. And he means the highest is أَفْعَلْ, أَوْثَقُ النَّاسِ, the opposite to what? أَكْذِبُ النَّاسِ. Then he says after that, ثِقَةٌ ثِقَةٌ, then ثِقَةٌ حَافِظٌ, and anything like that. And then last but not least, شَيْخ. All of that is what the author rahimahullah mentions.
قال رحمه الله تعالى وتقبل التزكية من عارف بأسبابها ولو من واحد على الأصح والجرح مقدم على التعديل إن صدر مبينا من عارف بأسبابه.
So the author, first thing he mentioned was what? The first I mentioned was مراتب الجرح. I said four things. So he mentioned مراتب الجرح والتعديل, right? Now the second thing that the author mentioned, which is who is tazkiyah accepted from. Now he mentioned who is accepted from. وَتُقْبَلُ التَّزْكِيَةُ مِنْ عَارِفٍ بِأَسْبَابِهَا وَلَوْ مِنْ وَاحِدٍ عَلَى الْأَصَحِي. Who is accepted from? Who is the jarh? Who is the tazkiyah accepted from? Are you with me, brothers? The tazkiyah, you can't just praise who you want. It needs who are you to praise this person? It has to be a person who knows the reasons, even if it's one person. The third point that he mentions about jarh wa ta'adil is that the jarh takes precedence over the disparagement. إِمْ صَدَرَ مُبَيِّنًا مِنْ عَارِفٍ بِأَسْبَابِهِ. But if it comes from somebody who knows its reasons. If you see a scholar that criticized, and you see a scholar that what? That disparaged him. Who are you going to give precedence to? The criticism takes precedence over the disparagement. The criticism and the disparagement takes precedence over the praise. Over the praise, jazakallah. Are you with me, brothers? Then the fourth point that he mentioned is what?
والجرح مقدم على التعديل إن صدر مبينا من عارف بأسبابه فإن خلا عن تعديل قبل مجملا على المختار.
That's the fourth one. What's the ruling? The fourth point that he mentions is what? What is the hukum of jarh al-mujmal? A jarh which is ambiguous. The man, he doesn't mention the reason why he's disparaging him. He's not mentioning the reason. He just criticizes him. The author says, in khala an qubil, in khala an ta'adil. So Ibn Hajar says it's accepted with the condition that there's no praise that's already standing. If there's a praise that's standing regarding him, some people have praised him. And you have to give us a jarh mufassar. You have to explain why you're criticizing him. But if you're just saying, لا تقد عنه الحديث, لا لا تأخذ عنه الحديث. And you say that. Yeah? And there are jibal mountains who've praised him. Then, sorry. Are you with me, brothers? نعم.
ومعرفة كن المسمين وأسماء المكنين ومن اسم ومن اسمه كنيته ومن اختلف في كنيته.
Now the author talks about معرفة كن المسمين. He talks about the issue that's known as knowing the people's kunya. Kunya is a plural and the jama of kunya. And it is anything that precedes it, ma subiqa bi ab ama It's anyone you say abu fulan and ab ummu, this, sah? Or other than that. And the name is what? Is your name, sah? So knowing the asma'ul mukannaini, you should give time to learning that as well.
ومن كثرت كناه أو نعوته ومن وافقت كنيته اسم أبيه أو العكس.
So trying to learn a person's name and his kunya. Also ومعرفة من اختلف في كنيته, the one whose kunya has been differed upon, specifying it. Or a person whose kunya has become too much and his description. Yeah.
ومن وافقت كنيته اسم أبيه أو العكس أو كنيته كنية زوجته ومن
So also learning that one, which is anyone whose kunya is in agreement with the kunya of his father. Sorry, so كنيته اسم أبيه. His kunya is his father's name. Or opposite. Or كنيته is the kunya of زوجته, his wife. Finding that out as well.
ومن نسب إلى غير أبيه أو إلى غير ما يسبق للفهم ومن اتفق اسمه واسم أبيه وجده أو اسم شيخه وشيخ شيخه فصاعدا ومن اتفق اسم شيخه والراوي عنه ومعرفة الأسماء المجردة والمفردة وكذا الكنى والألقاب والأنساب وتقع إلى القبائل والأوطان بلادا أو ضياعا أو سككا أو مجاورة وإلى الصناعي والحرف ويقع فيها الاتفاق والاشتباه كالأسماء وقد تقع ألقابا ومعرفة أسباب ذلك ومعرفة الموالي من أعلى ومن أسفل من أسفل بالرق أو بالحلف ومعرفة الإخوة والأخوات.
The author رحمه الله he says knowing a person's mere name ومعرفة الأسماء المجردة the person's mere name والمفردة the singular name his kunya his nickname His ansab lineage, tribes and countries, trying to learn it. Also neighboring places. Sometimes some people are named after their professions, like Chaudhary here. So Chaudhary is a profession, right?
The head of tribes.
Like England, Smith. For example, Smith is a blacksmith or? So it's a hirfa. Where did it come from? You know, Dar Qutn, it comes from Dar Qutn. The Dar of what? Cotton. So you have to find out where this, how is it working here? Where does it come? All of this is something you study. Books talk about this. It's needed when you're speaking about Ilm al-Hadith. You have to know these stuff. That's what you need. If it's a name that came from a profession, you find out. وَيَقَعُ فِيهِ الْإِتِّفَاقُ وَالْإِشْتِبَاهُ Things that are similar and that look like one another. Okay? Also trying to learn مَعْرِفَةُ أَسْبَابِ ذَلِكَ وَمَعْرِفَةُ الْمَوَالِي مِنْ أَعْلَى وَمِنْ أَسْفَلِ بِالرَّقِّ أَوْ بِالْحِلْفِ A person who went through slavery. Okay? And it is like, for example, sometimes you realize that some people's names are attributed to a people. Is it because it's from the angle of that they were once a slave for them? Like Imam Bukhari, rahimahullah, he's جُعْفِيُّ مَوْلَاهُمْ جُعْفِي, he's not from those people. He was once a slave. Anyone who brought you into Islam, you'll take their family lineage. That's it, you're part of the family now. That's how it used to be. Okay? Whereas Imam Muslim, he's what? Al-Qushayriyu. Qushayri is a qabila min qaba'il al-Arab. Imam Muslim is an Arab. Some scholars try to say, is he a what? Is he from Qushayr? From the angle of wala allegiance. That they brought him into Islam or something like that, you need to find out. No, it's not. He's actually from these people. These are his people. You look at this. You listen, you try to learn brothers and sisters who are related to one another. معرفة الإخوة والأخوات. Also معرفة الآداب الشيخ وطالب.
ومعرفة آداب الشيخ والطالب وسن التحمل والأداء.
The reason I'm going over this fast is معرفة آداب الشيخ والطالب. We're going to see some of these points in Sheikh Saleh Ibn Abdullah Ibn Hamad Al-Usaymi's kitab تعظيم العلمي. Also learning the age which you're allowed to take narrations. What old age do you have to be in order to take narrations? And what age are you to pass over that narration? You have to know. The description, how do you write hadith and how do you present hadith? وسماعي, how do you listen to a narration? How do you allow others to listen to that narration? All of that you try to learn. Now that you traveling to all of this you learn, if this person has traveled as well, you find a narrator who you're speaking about, has he traveled? How many places has he traveled to? Who has he met? Because this is going to allow you to know if this narration is connected or disconnected. Not to mention, this is the science of traveling and how it was. You need to understand that as well. Now the author says, وَتَصَانِيفِهِ. You have to try to learn the different books of hadith and how they're written. How are the books of hadith written? For example, some of them are what? Huh? Al-Masanid. Some of them are Masanid. Masanid means what? A hadith that are written regarding companions. Like if you look at Muslim Imam Ahmad, the first hadith is the hadith of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. You open it, it's all in one place. Then Umar, then Uthman, then Ali, like that. Ashar al-Mubashirin bil Jannah are the first 10 he brings. He's not going to mix them all up, all in one place. That's how it's written. This is a Musnad. The Musnad is written like this. Hayya ala al-abwabi. Hadiths are written in chapters and how they're chaptered like this. Hayya?
على المسانيد أو الأبواب أو العلل.
أحاديث books of علل. How they work. علل علي بن المديني. العلل الواردة by دارقطني. ودخول ابن أبي حاتم's كتاب جرح التعديل. And other books. You open them and you look at them. These are books you need. Not in your library to be fancy on the wall. But you know how they work. When you want to research this, which one is for which? Because some of the books are for the du'afa only. Are you going to look for the thiqat in the du'afa? You're looking for the reliable narrators. Are you going to look for them in the weak books? No. You need to know. Some books are only about what? A particular qutb min aqtar al-ard. They only talk about Tariq Dimashq. It's only about Dimashq. Don't try to... Tariq Baghdad is only Baghdad. Some books are thiqat only, reliable scholars. Some are du'afa only. Some are tabaqat, narrators and their tabaqah. Some are only not juz. A only particular thing they want to bring a narrations on. Nothing more, nothing less. You have to know how these books work. How the scholars author their works, or else you're going to get tired. Ayah? And atraf, a hadith which are atraf, a hadith that the end, if you're looking back in the days, there was no shamila where you just press the button and it comes out. A hadith which are atraf, a hadith that tell you the beginning of the wording of the hadith and you can find it in the books of hadith. For example, Al-Imam Kitab al-Sharaf written by Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi rahimahullah. Is one book you can use. Would you call it the kitab written by Ibn Hajar? What's it called? What's it called? Al-Mahara. Ittihaf al-Mahara, written by Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah ta'ala. Ittihaf al-Mahara. You buy it. Also Ibn Hajar, what did he do? All of the thamani masanid, all of the 8 Muslims there are, he took a book and he compiled it all in one place. And he called it Matalim al-Aliyah. Called it? Matalib al-Aliya. You read these books and you look at them. They should not just be in your library. Hey.
ومعرفة سبب الحديث. وقد صنف فيه بعض شيوخ القاضي أبي يعلى بن الفراء.
الإمام القاضي أبي يعلى الفراء. He authored a book. His name is Abu Hafs Umar ibn Ibrahim al-Ukburi al-Hanbali رحمه الله تعالى. His name is Abu Hafs. His name is Abu Hafs Umar ibn Ibrahim al-Ukbari al-Hanbali. He's the author, rahimahullah, wa huwa Abu Ya'la ibn al-Farra, rahimahullah ta'ala. Naam.
وصنف في غالب هذه الأنواع وهي نقل محض ظاهرة التعريف مستغنية عن التمثيل وحصرها متعسر فلتراجع لها مبسوطاتها والله الموفق والهادي لا إله إلا هو.
The author then says وصنفوا في غالب هذه الأنواع. Scholars have generally written books on each of these points that I mentioned, okay, and bringing them together. And here is just a naql mahab. This whole book of mine, humility and humbleness. All of this you can find in many, many other places. I just naql. That's what I did. And you can find it if you wanted to. فليراجع لها مبسوطاتها. If you want to go more in details, go for the books which are detailed and expand these things. والله الموفق والهادي لا إله إلا الله. The author, he finished and concluded there. وبهذا نكون قد فرقنا بحمد الله من الكتاب. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.